It's a hockey night in Pittsburgh. Tonight from the Consol Energy Center in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the National Hockey League presents the Pittsburgh Penguins and the New York Rangers. A pretty good career in the NHL. Gave it away at center, though, to Bortuzzo. Now he's falling into the zone. Shoots it, and he missed on the stick outside of netminder Lundqvist. He had him at his mercy. Penguins back. Malkin with it. Shoots it. Jumps up in the air right on the top of the net. Whistle sounds. Malkin shot it and deflected up and went up on top of the cage and settled there. And then the whistle.
The exact same thing happened in New York. The Penguins had a golden opportunity against Lundqvist. And he makes saves sometimes. And in watching him, it looks like he doesn't even know he makes the saves. It's positioning. He's so solid positionally that he makes saves because he's square to the shooter. And about this puck bounces straight up in the air and sits right on the top of the net.
Into the near corner for Rick Nash. Nash carries it around, sets up Boyle. High slot, slapper redirected and stopped off the chest of Fleury on the redirect by Brassard. An outlet pass comes to center to Brandon Sutter. He moves into the Rangers zone with St. Louis chasing. Gets a backhand shot off, stop, rebound. Comes to the tang and he's stopped by Lundqvist.
He's just so durable and he's not a very big guy. And no. He looks big. I mean, his equipment that he wears is right to the maximum. He wears as big as you possibly can wear, but you're right, incredibly strong and fit and athletic.
Here are the Penguins again, back in from the left wing side. They fire the puck and Hornquist will give the Penguins a 1-0 lead over Tacoma. Well, Henry had that one get away from him. And so the Penguins strike first and take a 1-0 lead. Como from that left wing side. Let the shot go.
It was Hornquist with the center lane drive, Mikey, backing off Dan Girardi. And, you know, Dan Girardi likes to block a lot of shots. And he goes down. He might have screened his goaltender a little bit. And very rarely do you see a puck break through the body of Henrik Lundqvist. A lot of spin on this puck. It's just a little pop one-timer down on one knee by Blake Como. And back in the lineup comes Como. And he gives the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
For Como, his fourth of the year. And here were the Rangers trying to tie it. In front they will. Right back on the attack. And it looked like Stepniak might have been the guy right in front. And he finishes it off with a backhander. And the Rangers have tied this game. They come right back. It did not take long.
Confusion. It starts with a puck jumping over the stick of Rob Scuderi and then mass confusion by the Penguins, and the Rangers do a good job. They saw the Penguins were flat-footed. Sidney Crosby wasn't really sure who to take. Do I take Stepniak? Do I not take Stepniak? And the puck comes from the point, and I think it bounces off of Sid, off of Stepniak, down to his feet, and the quick hands of Lee Stepniak pops it over Marc-Andre Fleury's right pad, just like that. It's 1-1.
Yeah. Fans here didn't even have an opportunity to celebrate the Como goal. Stepniak answers, 1-1. Right side delivery. They set it back down to Boyle. Boyle onto the right wing boards. And Louis gets it to Nash. Back they go all the way to Boyle. Left side to Stepan. Big shot, save made. Rebound. Penguins there. Can they clear? They can't. Penguins have Adams and Sutter out here as penalty killers. Rangers again moving that puck around brilliantly. Center point to Boyle. Shot off the glove of Fleury. Rebound in front. St. Louis sets it up and a shot, and he scores, and the Rangers have a 2-1 lead. Marty St. Louis and Brassard help teaming up in front. And the Rangers get a power play goal, and they've got the lead here in Pittsburgh.
Boy, did that look easy.
Yes, it did.
Tremendous puck movement by the Rangers, and they were able to move the puck so quickly and efficiently, in my estimation, Mikey, is because the Penguins are standing still. Not on their toes, not active with their sticks, kind of standing and watching quite a bit. And when the shot comes from Danny Boyle, the one-timer from the center point, Marc-Andre Fleury makes the initial save, does his job, but then the Penguins are standing around watching. And Brassard does a great job to corral the rebound in front of Marc-Andre Fleury and then throw it over to Marty St. Louis, who's walking in from the half wall. It's a perfect pass for the one-timer, and he pops it up over Marc-Andre Fleury. It's 2-1 Rangers.
Well, he's a big body in front of that net. Martin trying to clear him out. Right point, Girardi shooting. Pad saved by Fleury. Rebound in front. Stepniak just missed there.
Broken stick from Martin. He gets one from Adams. Except it's a right-hand stick. Martin's left-handed.
And Martin looking now to stop the play. And a wrist shot to the goal. Stopped by Fleury. The rebound jumps out, but the whistle, it sounded. It came out of the glove hand or off the body of Fleury. And the referee lost sight of the puck and immediately blew the whistle. And a huge break for the Penguins there because that puck was loose.
It was loose. It was free. And Kreider on a flyby just went right over the puck. And then you had Stempniak in there pitchforking away. And from our vantage point here, we could see puck was loose in the blue paint.
Around the boards to the right side of Evgeny Malkin. Malkin center point to Dupuis. Dupuis finding Crosby. Crosby looking down low. Hornquist and Dupuis team up, trying to get that puck in. Hornquist chopping away at it. Not going to be able to do it as Dan Boyle stands up. Patrick Hornquist. And play is whistled down with a face-off taking place now in Rangers ice to the right of Henrik Lundqvist.
I'd like to see the Penguins use this play more as Crosby walks off the near half wall. Now he needs a sell shot to make this play work as Hornquist bumps out to give him a nice passing lane to the right of Henrik Lundqvist. And as soon as Hornquist gets the puck, he pulls it hard into his body and into the feet of Henrik Lundqvist and then starts pitchforking away.
Mark Madden from 2-3, Steve Colby from 3-5, and Brian Mitzer from 5-6. Here are the Penguins with the steals, falling to the Rangers in, over to Malkin, he shoots and scores! Malkin from the right wing circle, finishes it against Lundqvist, and the Penguins have tied this game in two. Let's go, Hunt Foose on a Harley, Evgeny Malkin.
Oh, that's just what the Penguins needed, a generous bounce. And they take full advantage. Dan Boyle backtracking into his own zone, has his head up. Tries a long pass, it just flubs off his stick and goes right to Nick Spaulding. And Spaulding attacks the goal, he draws attention from the defenseman John Moore and then slides a perfect one-timer pass to Evgeny Malkin, down on one knee, he rips it. It goes off Lundqvist, off the post, off Lundqvist and into the net. We're tied at two.
Giving a puck to Crosby, right back to Dupuis and out on the tank. He enters the Rangers zone on the right side. Softly sent into the corner. Mark Stahl reaches for it. Kunitz made him pay the price. Put a body check on him. Broussard, though, supports. Gave it away. Dupuis in front to Kunitz. And he's stopped by Lundqvist from right in front of the net. To the right point, it comes to Letang. And the man advantage, Pittsburgh, sets it up for Hornquist. And the left wing boards. Back to the left point to Malkin. Quickly to Chris Letang. Very aggressive penalty killing by the Rangers. They come out to meet. Hornquist throws it to the net. And it's off the left pad. The rebound goes to Crosby. And he missed the target.
He could just pop it in the empty net, but on the backhand, high degree of difficulty.
Rangers again deliver it to Penguin Real Estate. And Crosby up off the sideboards with 35 to go in regulation. The Rangers get it near St. Louis. Storming ahead of the Penguins in a Nash. Shooting the puck. Stopped by Fleury from 30 feet. He makes the save. We begin overtime. Moving right to left will be the Pens. Penguins control the faceoff. And Letang and Martin on the backside. It's Kreider and Stepan for the Rangers. Klein and Stahl on the backside. They pass to Crosby. He's got a breakaway. Coming to the net. Shoots. Good save by Lundqvist. Off his right pad. Crosby had a chance to win it there. But a huge save by Lundqvist on his right pad. Rushing up by the Rangers here. Running out of time. The right side to Kreider. Turns it over to Broussard. Right wing boards. Moves into the right wing circle. Left side. One time. Shot. Fleury the save. The left side area by Girardi. His shot. Kreider again. Blocked. Sutter gets out. Letang takes the pass. He's got a breakaway in and goal, and he's stopped by Lundqvist with a glove save as time runs out here with 4.8 seconds to go. Letang came out of the penalty box. He was allowed to get out. And as he came racing out of the box, the puck came to him from Sutter, had a breakaway chance, and Henrik Lundqvist saved the day, at least for now, for the New York Rangers.
That's twice in overtime. Crosby with the breakaway?
Yes.
And Letang with a breakaway. Crosby tried to go five-hole. Letang tries to go up the ladder. And Henrik Lundqvist just flailing his left hand up in the air. A little bit circus-like. But how about the play by Brandon Sutter to block the puck, down on one knee, get to the wall, find it, get the head up, move his feet, and find Letang coming out of the box with a perfect pass to spring him on the breakaway.
Here we go. Evgeny Malkin, the first shooter, slows the pace. Coming in on Lundqvist. Goes to the quick shot in tight, and the stick of goaltender Lundqvist stopped Malkin from in tight. He slowed the pace down so much, he kind of ran out of room, and then Lundqvist got his stick down at the same time when he shot it. Didn't have much on him.
No, Lundqvist has incredible patience. He's going to wait you out if you come with that slow a speed.
First shooter for the New York Rangers will be Derek Stepan. The right-hander crosses the blue line wide to the left, moves into the left-wing circle, comes down a wristing one, off the stick of Florian in the net. And it is 1-0 in the shootout for the New York Rangers. Sidney Crosby will be the Penguins' second shooter. Number 87 doesn't waste any time. Pushes the puck ahead, moving to the left side of the ice. Moves to the slot. He shoots it by 1 foot very quickly on a wrister. And he ties it for the Penguins as Crosby makes it 1-1 in the shootout.
Well, you usually don't see Sid go to the left side so wide. But he dusts the puck off a few times, sells 5-hole to Lundqvist, who went on the breakaway, and then goes up the ladder over the left glove hand.
Matt Zuccarello will be the second shooter for the New York Rangers. In the left-handed shooting, Ranger forward with number 36, moves right to the Penguin zone, comes in, and he got a poke ticked away by Fleury. He tried to make a last-second move to go to the back end, but Fleury outworked him and outthought him, and he put the stick out, never got a chance to get the shot away. And so the third shooter for the Penguins will be Chris Letang. And here he is, moving to the left. The right-hander coming down the slot. Really a slow tempo. Comes in, backhand shot. And Lundqvist, just with his right leg, made the stop. I believe he kicked it away.
He might have had the stick in there too, Mikey, on the poke check. My goodness. Lundqvist looked like he was completely out of the play. And it looked like Letang was going to go to the backhand and shelf it. What an athletic save by Henrik Lundqvist.
Dan Boyle will be the third shooter for the New York Rangers. The right-handed shooting defenseman can win it for the Rangers now. He slides into the Penguins' end, comes to the slot, goes to the forehand. And did he get it in? Yes, he did. The Rangers win. He got it by Fleury, and the New York Rangers will get the extra point as Boyle delivers in a big way. Fleury got the leg out, but it came off his skate and in the net, and the Rangers win.
But from my side, it looked like it went off the post. And he double hit it. We got to replay this, guys. Hey, this I don't think this game should be over. He double hit this puck. Watch this. One, and he hit it in again. It should be no goal. You got to take that back. That's not a goal. You can't hit it in. He knocked in the rebound. Yeah, well, they're blowing the horn here, folks. This isn't a goal. This game is going to continue. He double hit this puck into the net. This puck went off the goal post. Off the goal post. Boyle hit it again. Well, take a look. Off the goal post. And then Boyle, second shot, hits it in on the rebound. You can't do that. And this game, I don't believe it's over. I think they're going to have to bring the teams back on the ice. As he double hit that puck into the net, and they got a call from the NHL right now. And Sidney Crosby's coming back out. And we have not seen this. We have not seen this in a long time, ever. I can't remember ever the teams going to the dressing room like this. And I think we're going to continue to play here, folks. There's no question that Boyle hit that. Yep. Come on back. No goal. And it's a great thing that we have replay. Would have been a terrible way for a game like this to end. Half the people may have left the building here. Listen for the call. Well, Malkin's smiling because he hasn't shot yet, has he? Yeah, he was the first Penguin to shoot, so the Penguins have the next shooter up, and we'll see who they come out with.
I'm guessing Sutter.
Sutter?
On the New York shootout, the Ranger player shoots the puck, hits the post, goes back off the Ranger player in the net. It's a double hit and no goal.
What a hockey game. Take a look at this. So Boyle goes to shoot the puck, hits the goal post, and he hits it back in. Double hit. No goal. There's the one. One. Double hits it. No goal.
It's Brandon Sutter, the fourth shooter for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Hallelujah, Hollywood. He has the puck. Crossing the blue line. Comes against Lundqvist. Wrister, and he scores! Brandon Sutter gives the Penguins the lead in the shootout. As he connects the right-handed snapshot to beat Lundqvist. And now it's the Rangers here with their four shooter. They will have to score to keep it going. And Rick Nash chips him with the board. The big burly winger, leading the team and scoring with goals, comes across the blue line. Left-handed shooter walking to the net, goes in with a backhander. Flurry stops him, game over. And ladies and gentlemen, what a turn of events. Elvis has just left the building. The Penguins win it. Pittsburgh 3 and the Rangers 2. And you'd have to be here to believe it.
40 years in the booth for you. Have you ever seen that, partner?
Never, ever, ever.
One of the craziest endings you'll ever, ever hear about, folks. The goal by Danny Boyle was disallowed because it went off the post and then he hit it in. You cannot hit the puck after it hits the post. Once it hits the post, it's over, it's dead. And then Brandon Sutter goes 5-hole on Lundqvist, and what a ridiculous glove save Marc-Andre Fleury makes on Rick Nash to give the Penguins the 2 points. Oh, baby.
Now the Penguins file off, and for the final time tonight, they'll head to the locker room. I'm sure of this.